Good afternoon. I'm Pam Carnes, President and CEO of the Cherokee County Chamber of Commerce. And today on Tuesday's topic, I have the good fortune of visiting with Anita Summers. Anita is the director of the Sequoia Regional Library System, which serves Cherokee, Pickens, and Gilmer counties. Their office is in Cherokee. So who better to talk to today than Anita to find out what's happening with our library system, when you might can go back, when you might can return a book. Anita and I had a short conversation before I hit record, and there's so much that's up in the air right now. I think that's for everybody, not just the library system, but she doesn't want to tell you too much so that you're disappointed. But I promise you what you're going to hear is that the library system is alive and well in Cherokee, Pickens, and Gilmer. I happen to be a member of the library board, so I feel rest assured and very confident in that. But Anita, thank you for being on our call this afternoon.
Well, you're very welcome. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Well, you are so welcome. And I have learned, and I shared this recently during a library board Zoom meeting, that I've learned so much about the library system in the 3 years that I've served on the board, and really taking a step back to realize it's more than just checking out books. So congratulations to you and your team for surviving during this unprecedented time. You've really had to operate differently than ever before, definitely working outside the box, because you truly are people that open your doors to serve others. So thank you for what you and your team have done, and share with us about what the latest situation is, what you're thinking from a perspective of getting people back into the library, whatever you feel comfortable sharing, we hope that you will. So take it away.
Okay, thank you, Pam. Well, I just want to start out by saying that we have been still here serving the public, even while we were closed. We've had virtual services for years, but you know, they've really come to the forefront now that people can't actually visit the library buildings. So we've really tried to promote those and make sure people understand how to use them. We're our contact us form on the website. We're answering all kinds of questions. So we are here. It's just different. And but we are in the midst of planning. We are making progress. We have staff who are starting to come back and get things ready. We're looking at a new service model that we're going to have to use for a while. So just to give you a little hint of what we're looking at is that we're looking at establishing a service, a pickup service, where people can come and pick things up at the library. We're working out all of those details now and procedures, because we do anticipate that we're going to have a lot of people wanting to take advantage of that.
Sure.
Based on the input we're getting, the questions we're getting, we know that people are ready, and we're ready to see everybody. We miss everybody terribly. It's going to be a little different at first, but this will be our first step, and we're just taking it one step at a time. You know, like every other organization out there, we really can't predict too far into the future of what's going to happen, but we're thinking ahead, trying to look at all the things. We know what we'd like to do. We just don't know when we can do these things. But I guess the closest I can say is that very, very soon, I think you'll be seeing an announcement about when those things can start and when you can start bringing books back and arranging to pick books up. So.
Well, and I think being able to fill our minds right now with positive things like that latest book that we want to read, a perfect way to do that. But I know that thinking about children that have been accustomed to getting to visit the libraries for story time, they've still been able to do that, haven't they?
That's right. Our incredible staff has just taken it upon themselves to learn how to do virtual programming just right off the bat when we closed. Now we have more and more staff learning that, so we actually have sort of a schedule, if you will.
Right.
So you can go on our website and look for online programming and find out when the programs are coming up online and watch a story time or participate in another kind of program online. Okay. And a lot of people are discovering ebooks and e-audiobooks for the first time and e-magazines. You know, we have those kind of things available as well. And then for schoolwork and for business, we have databases that people can access. We are signing up people for library cards online. I mean, we're just doing, you know, all these things we did to a certain extent before. Now they're that's where everything is happening now. Is virtually.
We're just figuring out how to do that. Right. Yes.
And it's interesting. Some of the things that we've wanted to do for many years, like do some instructional videos that we could post online, we just never seem to really have the time to step back and do those. Well, we've had time. And so we've been taking advantage of this time and having our staff learn how to do some new things. Of course, we're having meetings online, our staff meetings, our board meetings. So that's been a learning process. So in spite of everything bad that's going on, there's so much good there too that I think is going to benefit us in the long run. We're really connecting with our community in new ways that I think will continue even after people come back in our building. And one thing before I forget, I want to mention is that we have free Wi-Fi. Of course, we've had it inside our buildings for many years.
Right.
Our access points inside the building did extend somewhat outside the building, but that wasn't really what they were intended for. So after this crisis happened, we invested in some outside access points. So all of our libraries now have outdoor access points. These were installation was finished last week. So if by chance you visited us earlier, you know, and couldn't get our Wi-Fi to work properly, you know, come back and try it now. Don't need a password. It will ask you to accept the conditions. You know, there'll be a little screen that comes up. So, you know, don't let that throw you. But yes, it is open, no password. So we hope that people will take advantage of that, because we know that, you know, a lot of people may not have internet, or they may have had to, you know, drop their internet because of the, you know, the situation or just whatever reason. But it's there for anyone who needs it. So we're very, very happy to be able to provide that.
That's great, because in some situations it's too many people within the home all trying to use that same.
Exactly.
Yes. It's like having to, you know, conserve energy. They're conserving their internet. There's not enough for maybe the mom and dad to be working remotely, and then a couple of children at home that are taking online classes. So what a great way to get community than by visiting one of your local libraries and utilizing it there. Well, I appreciate the fact that you've mentioned that pickup service may be available soon, just based on I'm accustomed to reserving a book online. So that's a pretty good deal. I can reserve it online and then I can just go by and get ready to pick it up without having to go inside. We can social distance that way. I know that there are people that feel under pressure because they have books that needed to be returned. The book drops have been closed. When they get ready to return those books, will they incur late fees for those?
No, there will be no late fees. We don't have any plans right this moment of when fees will, late fees will return. Right now, we're just going to focus on our new service model and getting those books returned and getting back to some sense of normalcy.
Great. That's what we need to hear, because what you're doing is offering exceptional customer service without us ever having to cross that threshold by walking in the door. And I think that's what so many businesses and organizations have been doing. Many, like the Chamber, have said, we have to step back now that we begin to return to what life was like to determine now what will we take away. Things like Tuesday topic, things like our The Chamber Matters on Monday and every other day of the week, our Thursday thoughts. Things that we've gotten accustomed to over the course of the last 7 weeks that we don't necessarily want to remove from our business model. So I, again, admire you and your team. Y'all have worked diligently. You've definitely continued to provide services in the communities that you represent, and we can't thank you enough. So I'm ready for the day that, yes, that we can walk back in the door. But until then, it's a good feeling to know about what is available to us. I also want to give a plug for a chamber initiative that is focused on retiring educators. Now, for some 11 years, the chamber has, in partnership with the library system, been supporting retiring educators in the community in tandem with a business or organization in the county that is sponsoring the effort this year. It once again happens to be Chattahoochee Technical College. The college has donated funds to the library system so that they can purchase books. And then those books will all have a label inside the front cover that says that they have been given in honor of an educator in Cherokee County, and in this case, the 2019-2020 year. So that was what you and I had emailed about the other day, is maybe the book drops would be open soon, because we need to drop those labels off to Anita as well as that sponsorship check. Yes, but thank you for that partnership and for allowing us to support those educators by you all choosing the books that you feel like are needed and making those great choices to continue to fill your shelves for those minds in Cherokee County that want to soak up as much as they can through the love of reading. So thank you for all you do. It's great to see you on Zoom. I just saw Anita just a few days ago on Zoom for library board meeting, and it was kind of rainy that afternoon and I didn't get to sit outside. So I will miss my outdoor Zoom calls as we venture back to the office. But, you know, we have a terrace there. We have outdoor furniture. I may have to continue to go outside. But Anita, anything you'd like to add before we sign off?
Well, first of all, just going back to the retired educators, I think that's a wonderful way to honor the retired educators, and we're glad to be a part, play our part in that. But I would just encourage people to come online and contact us through our website, through our social media, and then hopefully very soon we'll be talking to people on the phone and we'll be helping them with selecting books, and we just are very excited about that. But thank you again for this opportunity.
You're welcome. Remind us of that web address.
Oh, SequoiaRegionalLibrary.org.
SequoiaRegionalLibrary.org. You've heard it here on Tuesday Topic, so look online and see what else is happening with the Sequoia Regional Library System. And Anita, I hope to get to see you face-to-face soon, and we hope to get to see lots of patrons coming into the libraries as well.
And we will make those announcements on that. So that's where you Perfect. Need to go to find out the latest. That's where we'll post it first.
Perfect. We'll add that to your history on your computer so that you can go back. As they would say in one of the funny things about voting is early and often. We just want them to visit you often to see yes. what's happening. But thanks again for all you do, and I will see you soon.
Thank you, Pam. See you soon.